Moi, ce qui m'intéresse dans cette université, c'est justement, quand on parle de cuisine, évidemment, ça m'influence pour d'autres recherches. L'agriculture, quelle gastronomie pour 2020, 2050 même. On annonce 9 milliards d'individus sur cette planète. Il va falloir apprendre à vivre encore mieux ensemble et à partager la richesse de cette planète.
Depuis 1942, la faculté d'agriculture de l'Université de Jérusalem est le berceau de toutes les grandes réalisations agricoles d'Israël.
Hello, who are you?
Thierry Marx.
All right, thank you very much.
Thanks.
La faculté d'agriculture est l'un des organismes de recherche les plus innovants au monde. Afin de répondre aux défis de demain, ces scientifiques développent des innovations dans les domaines de la nutrition et de la santé, que ce soit de l'eau potable que nous buvons, aux médicaments que nous absorbons. Autant de sujets fondamentaux qui passionnent Thierry Marx. Ce jour-là, il a rendez-vous avec Benny Khefetz, le doyen de l'université.
Hello.
Hello, how are you?
I'm fine, thank you. Welcome to the campus of the Faculty of Agriculture. We are here in Rehovot. The Faculty of Agriculture was established back in 1942, about 6 years before the State of Israel was established. Our campus was established as a small agricultural experimental station with 21 students in the first class. Back then, this area was the heart of the agricultural activity during the British Mandate. And the rationale was to establish, to introduce new agricultural practices, new cultivars, in order to feed the growing nation. About 10 years ago, the name of the faculty has been changed to the Faculty of Agriculture, Food and Environment. Because in our vision for the future, we need to increase yields. However, we have to make sure that we maintain a healthy environment and we provide functional food for everybody. We have to realize that for every kilogram of a beefsteak that we consume, we need more than 50,000 liters of water. And this is a huge amount. And we don't have that water in the Middle East, and we don't have that water globally. So therefore, we have to move toward more vegetarian type of diet in order to maintain enough food for everybody. So I'm happy to invite you to our lovely campus to meet our researchers. Please.
Thank you.
Thierry Marx poursuit sa visite avec le professeur Ram Refen. Ce dernier projette de créer un centre de sécurité alimentaire afin de regrouper sous un même toit des spécialistes de médecine, de nutrition et d'agronomie.
So you know, Thierry, we have an outstanding blend here of researchers from different disciplines that are actually synergistic. You know, the vision of the Faculty of Agriculture is to feed the world that is going to become huge. In 2050, we shall be 10 billion people. So we have here animal sciences, and we have food technologists, we have plant scientists and soil scientists. And together, we can work ensemble towards excellent food security for the world.
What exactly is a food security?
Well, food security exists when people have sufficient, safe, and nutritious food that can be not only to fulfill their dietetic requirements, but also to lead healthy life. We want to found now a center here for food security, all the disciplines together.
For what challenge?
You know, we have here now a startup where we can make out of chickpea 90% protein of chickpea. You can smell it and see that it has a neutral taste, and a very good taste that can actually be good for meat analogs or dairy analogs and more, and replace some of the requirements for protein.
La mission des chercheurs de l'Université hébraïque consiste à développer des solutions innovantes afin de faire de l'alimentation notre première médecine. Parmi les découvertes majeures de la faculté d'agriculture, une a particulièrement retenu l'attention de Thierry Marx, celle du professeur Oren Tiroche, qui a démontré les vertus anti-neurodégénératives des fruits de la passion.
What we found is that how this passion fruit will protect neuronal cells, and we found that it is highly protective against different kind of toxic stress to the neuronal cells. which are relevant to neurodegenerative diseases. There are not many foods that are both delicious and healthy.
Machanif travaille sur les molécules responsables du goût. Ses travaux sur les molécules du sucre lui permettent d'en amplifier la saveur afin de réduire les quantités. Elle cherche également à rompre l'association répulsive entre amertume et toxicité.
Bitter and sweet are some of the very basic taste modalities. And they are so basic that from very young age, even newborns actually have born reaction, either to be attracted to sweet or to be distracted or aversive to bitter. And so it was very interesting for us to study, first of all, what are the molecules that elicit the bitter taste, and there are a lot of them. And can we, from chemical structure, like the baby can do it from tasting, can we look at the chemical structure and say if it's bitter or not? And also we wanted to understand the relation between bitterness and toxicity.
Sharoni Shafir est un spécialiste du système cognitif et comportemental des abeilles.
Quand j'étais très jeune, j'ai appris le métier de pâtissier dans une société qu'on appelle les compagnons des devoirs. Et leur modèle, depuis les temps très anciens, c'est la ruche. L'organisation, la compétence, la multiplicité des compétences pour servir une communauté avec un leader. Pourquoi les abeilles sont importantes pour nous, les hommes?
Our food safety diversity relies on pollination by bees. About 75% of the diversity of what we eat is pollinated by bees.
Explique-nous un petit peu comment vit la ruche et comment elle communique entre elles.
To run a city like this of tens of thousands of individuals, we need to have a communication system. When one forager bee, a bee that brings nectar or pollen, comes back, she dances and says in what direction is the food, how far it is, and her subjective evaluation, how excited she is about this food. Now we know for us, in our diet, we would eat a diet that was balanced about 1-to-1, omega-6 to omega-3. The modern Western diet is about 15-to-1, omega-6 to omega-3. We eat a lot of omega-6 and not enough of omega-3. And this is known to have a lot of health consequences, especially on our cognitive abilities, dementia, attention deficits. And we asked also do the same to bees. And we did a learning test with them. Clever bees that ate a good diet balanced with a lot of omega-3 reach about 95% learning in 3-4 trials. But bees that came from a diet that was lacking omega-3 could not learn. They go down to 40%, 45% learning. So a very big difference. So this is the first finding that omega-3 is important not only for our cognition, but also for that of an insect and a honeybee.
Et c'est très intéressant de voir comment ce modèle de société démocratique, finalement, parce qu'on élimine la reine à un moment donné, fonctionne encore aujourd'hui.
Zvi Peleg réinvente la culture du sésame. Après avoir sélectionné plus de 100 000 variantes de graines, il a réussi à développer un croisement de sésame qui offre un rendement 10 fois supérieur en qualité nutritive.
This is our sesame project that we are trying here to breed for better sesame with higher quality of nutrients. So we are doing a lot of crosses between different lines in order to make them more healthy. It's one of the 10 most healthier food on Earth. It's number one in zinc, in iron, in calcium, in any other nutrient. It's really a superfood. This is how the sesame look like when it's ripened. So you see that the capsule is open and then all the seeds are falling down. See, all my end is full. We have different colors that we are trying to breed for. We have this one that is completely white. It's more sweet if you taste it, so it's really nice. And this one is mainly used for making trini.
Genetic modification, no?
No, it's no. By classical genetic of crossing between different lines. And if people will eat only 4 teaspoons of either sesame seeds or trini, they're getting all the nutrients and all the iron they need for a day for adult plants.
La journée s'achève sur le campus de Rehovot. Thierry Marx retrouve Sophie Krief-Dabi de l'UAJ France et Zohar Kerem dans son laboratoire afin de tester le goût de la recherche.
Bonsoir Sophie, bonsoir Zohar. Merci. Alors mis à part de boire du vin dans ton université, qu'est-ce que tu fais dans cette université?
I'm a food scientist and in our faculty we take the cultivation, everything that is done by agriculture, and we make it into food, very healthy food, concentrated in protein, concentrated in vitamins. And our job is to make it also tasty, healthy and tasty. Our faculty is very special because we have the combination of agriculture, food, nutrition, economy. Mm-hmm. Agriculture economy is very unique to our faculty, and environmental protection. We use all the waste. Wastewater we use. Waste from the food we use. Waste from olives, we make olive oil. The waste, we learn how to use it in a better way. I tell them what I want in the food in the end. I wanted to have more iron. I tell them, you have to find something to have more iron in the sesame. And they bring me back sesame with more iron.
You test?
Allez, on goûte.
Okay. That's flavor. That's good.
60% Cabernet Franc. We also make bread. Normally bread is made of wheat or barley. We don't have a lot of protein in the bread. And also there are sometimes problems of gluten, so we develop different kinds of bread. One of the breads that we like very much is with the chickpea. If you combine wheat with chickpea, the combination is the best protein for us. So you don't need to eat beef. You can eat wheat with chickpea. So it affects satiety, it can fight obesity, it can add to the muscles if you're an athlete and you want muscles. So different combinations give better results.
Un petit peu d'eau, un petit peu de farine de pois chiche pour détendre. Il a levure et le sel. Il est intéressant de se dire que on peut utiliser la connaissance du passé pour créer le pain de demain.
Maybe we can, you know, we can change the world together.
Ah, with pleasure.
You bring your experience, we bring our experience together, we will change the world.
My pleasure. Voilà, on a fait la pâte. On va lui donner un petit peu de structure, de corps. Ensuite, on va la laisser pousser. Et puis, on va la diviser et on va faire des jolis petits pains. À tout à l'heure.